Dear fellow viewers, this intro and the following video is rated R for intensive, awesome video game violence and adult language, such as the words fuck, cock, shitbagger, dick, thunder, cunt, asshole, SOB, twat lips, and fucknut. Viewer discretion is advised. I do not advise to use diarrhea of the mouth at home, and don't do drugs, kids, just hug pugs. Thank you. Hey guys, it's Guns of Sympathy here, and you guys are probably wondering, you know, what happened to your intro? Why is it so short now? And it's not normally like that, but I'm gonna make the intro that short because I really need what I'm about to say in this video is more important than watching a 2-minute intro. So I made it as short as possible just so I can get my word out, my ideas out, and you know what I think. I should say, out in this video. So, what we're basically talking about, guys, well, before I even start, it's obvious to see that, this video you're gonna be watching awesome Halo 4 game footage that I made for you guys, for this video, so you guys can watch it. So, let me just say this. This video is about how, and this video is very serious too. I've been wanting to always make a video about this, but for some reason there's always been interruptions and everything, and I could never really fully let it out or properly say it. This video is about the lack of innovation in the gaming community and technology-wise in general and as a whole, and how there's too many unnecessary sequels in this gaming industry, and how everything's turning into a wreck, and how companies are copying other companies, and innovation is just basically dead. No one's making anything new. The features that are new are whack and are just recyclable. Same for gaming ideas and everything. And I want everyone to speak up and listen to me and make a change in the gaming community, because I take my gaming industry and the gaming community very serious. And I really doubt this video will get more than 100 views, or probably not even to 100. But I really need you guys to listen, and I'm worth my ideas like by tenfold, and I really want you guys to listen. So let me just start out by saying that innovation has gone downhill nowadays, basically, when it comes to gaming and like newly introduce things and ideas, such as consoles, to features, to ideas, to storytelling, to graphics in some extent, and as well as new titles have gone weak and repetitive. And I think the main reason being is because publishers don't want to lose money by taking a risk and making a new game, because they feel it will fail and bring down their business. So they keep making more and more unnecessary sequels like the Call of Duty franchise, and don't know when to stop, knowing that they're on a high alert of lack of innovation. Why? Because they're making the same shit over and over again. You know, such as Call of Duty, as I said before, Battlefield, and sadly Assassin's Creed even, and many other titles, you know. And basically, companies like Activision love making more and more and more and more and more and more and more titles of the same damn franchise, and they don't know when to stop. This needs to stop. This is destroying, annihilating, polluting the gaming industry by tenfold, and it's really damaging us as gamers in the gaming industry. I mean, I'm not a hater, but I'm pretty sure there's a gigantic large amount of people that are tired of seeing the word, the name, not the words, the name, and the title Call of Duty, and even the logo. Aren't you guys sick of it? Wouldn't you want to see some new damn ideas, innovations, and creations being made? Instead of seeing Call of Duty every damn year, it's getting very repetitive, getting very boring. I want to see new ideas in this damn generation. I'm tired of seeing all these unnecessary bullshit that publishers are forcing their developers to make for fucking money, because they know if they don't make money, because they're money whores, that their business will go down if they take a risk at making new fucking ideas. I'm getting sick and tired of it. Why don't we actually make a stand and stand up for once and speak and let our minds out and say this is not right? And I'm not expecting anybody to listen to me and not buy Call of Duty games. Go ahead and buy Call of Duty games. Fap to the fucking case if all I care. I'm just saying, this is getting so repetitive and I'm sick of seeing Call of Duty. And like I said, I'm not a hater. I'm a fucking true. If truther was a word, then that's what I would be. I'm telling the truth here. I am tired of seeing Call of Duty. I want to see new ideas made. Why? Because I'm sick of seeing the same bullshit over and over and over again. That's why. And, you know, I want to see more innovation when it comes to the gaming industry, and more new ideas when it comes to the gaming industry, because I love it so much, and I love when game developers create and flourish new ideas into the gaming industry to make you say, wow, you know, I've never seen an idea like that. You know, that's fresh. Wow, I never saw that before. Oh, that's so awesome. You know, I want to see that. I don't want to see the same bullcrap every year with minor little changes and improvements of a game. So just Call of Duty. I mean, I could name a few other titles that have been doing the same shit Call of Duty's been doing. But I say Call of Duty because that's like the biggest bang when it comes to my head to repetitive bullshit. So, guys, I'm just saying, we need to make a stand. We need to speak up. We need to speak up because if you are a true gamer and if you are tired of seeing the same bullcrap that fucking developers are making because publishers are forcing them to make them for fucking money, you know, you should speak up. You should speak up. If you were tired of seeing this crap, you should speak up. You shouldn't buy their products, one. And like I said, I'm not expecting like half of the world due to this fucking video not buy Call of Duty games. No, I'm not trying to say that. I just like to see new ideas in my games. And that's probably why most likely I'm going to become a gaming director, you know, because I want to be the one in charge. I don't want no one telling me what the fuck to do. I'm going to make my own fucking shit, and I'm going to make my own ideas, and I'm going to direct it. And if I'm making a storyline, right, and the main antagonist died in my story, that's it. That is it. There isn't going to be no prequels. There isn't going to be no unnecessary sequels after that and make up a new villain to keep continuing the story for money. No. Projects and video games have a start and an end. There's a start and an end to everything. And I'd rather end my franchise with a bang than keep repetitively making shit that's unnecessary, when I could be using all that money that I'm wasting on stupid bullshit on a new project, on new ideas, new innovation, to keep my fan base going, to keep my company going good, and also to have my game development team well respected for making new things and taking on new ideas and new challenges and new experiences when it comes to gaming. I wouldn't want them to keep on making more repetitive crap at the same time. Not only is it boring for the community, but how do you think those developers feel? Recycling gun ideas, gun sounds, gun models, and just recreating them. How do you think they feel? They must get bored making the same crap. And sure, they get tons of money. Sure, they get tons of money. But I mean, if they were true gamers and true game developers, they wouldn't give a fuck about the money. Because honestly, if I was a game developer, I wouldn't give a fuck about the money. I would give a fuck about my games, my gaming ideas, and the gaming industry as a whole, and what my community would think of my games and my products as a gaming director and a leader of a gaming development team, or both, publisher and development team. You know? I'm tired of these money whores. Like recently the past CEO of EA stepped down. He was one of the biggest money whores I know. I'm tired of people who don't know what gaming is or what the true meaning of gaming is into gaming industries or taking roles, unnecessary roles that they shouldn't even touch with any fingerprint of their fucking fingers. You know, I'm tired of people who are all in it for the money joining gaming industries when they don't know shit about games. The only thing they know is how much money they're gonna get. And I'm tired of it. You know? That's why back then, I liked it. I liked how it was back then in 2005 and 2006 when Halo, Devil May Cry, Gears of War, God of War, Psychonauts, Destroy All Humans, Nintendogs, Guitar Hero, and even Katamari was invented and created. Back then, new titles were coming out like no tomorrow. They were coming out like babies being born every 5 minutes in this damn planet and world. Now, it's every 2 years or every 3 years. Even it feels like when a new title comes out, because the whole year they introduce something, it's always sequels. Not to also mention, by you making more sequels, you're polluting and destroying the game industry because you are taking away the attention the new ideas should be getting, instead are letting the bullshit boring repetitive sequels get all the shine instead. Why do you think there's so many awesome underrated games these days, guys? Because unnecessary sequels are not giving new ideas oxygen to breathe and sprout and to actually be known. We need to speak up and save this industry, because if not, it will be destroyed by the bullcrap that I have already stated in this damn video. The gaming franchise needs to look back at its roots and create new things, you know, that will make good innovation. Because nowadays, innovation is barely shown, even the phones, the cars, to almost anything technology-wise. I mean, look at the iPhone 4S and the iPhone 5. What do you think has low reviews? Because Apple basically recycled the idea. There was no major improvements in the appearance. Most people can't even tell the difference between an iPhone 4S and an iPhone damn 5. No, not even. You could tell the difference because of the length and the phone. Most people can't tell the difference between a 4 and a 4S. And the only people that do know is, well, if you're a hardcore phone person, you know, it's ridiculous. And not only games, but, you know, technology, like I said, in general, you know, they need to make major changes. They need to make major changes. And you may say, oh, well, the appearance doesn't always need to be changed. Who knows? Maybe they changed some features. Yeah, they changed some features. But let me tell you this. I have an iPhone 5. And the only reason why I have an iPhone 5 is because this is, well, the first phone I ever got. The first iPhone I ever got. And at the time, it was the latest iPhone. So I'm an Apple fan, and I love it. But I'm just saying, in general, a person that buys an iPhone every year, or every year a new iPhone comes out, you're basically wasting your money, and you're basically destroying things that are new, being taken over by things that are the same shit. Like iPhones. You know, there's really no major differences in iPhones. I mean, what? I'm trying to think. The texting features maybe got better. I don't know. I'm not a big phone person, but I know the general shit about it. You know? And I really think we should fix the gaming industry, you know? Because I love games. My goal in life is to change this gaming industry and be a gaming developer and gaming director, because I love games and I have so many gaming idols like Ken Levine and Ed Boon and Jason West and Vincent Pella, the guys at Respawn who knew that Call of Duty was getting repetitive, so they left Activision. Because they thought that Modern Warfare 2 shouldn't have been the last Call of Duty, and it shouldn't have ended with a bang. Instead, Activision said, no, you're going to keep making Call of Duties. And they didn't want to do that. They wanted to make something new. A new idea. And then they left and went to EA to make Titan. And even made a new, gaming development team. See, those guys are a perfect example of true gamers. You want to know why? Because it took a lot of balls and guts to leave a company and lose all that money to go and waste even more money to make a new gaming development team and make a new game, all because of freedom, all because you couldn't get freedom from the past damn publisher you were signed by. They did all that just to get freedom on making what they wanted to make, and they were sick of people bossing them around and telling them what to make for fucking money by making unnecessary shit. I'm telling you guys, people should start speaking up. I'm telling you, we need to save this gaming industry and this gaming community. I don't give a fuck if I said it 50 damn times in this video. We need to do something. And if you're a true gamer, you would know. Xbox One. Look at it. Just look at what the fucking Xbox conference said. They showed everything but gaming. TV this. Did you know that we're going to have more TV this? TV that. We are introducing a new Halo television series. Call of Duty this, Call of Duty that. The newest feature that we've added that's a big improvement from the past Call of Duties is a dog. Wow. Guys, you can tell, and you may not want to say it, but you can tell innovation is getting weak. And you can tell gaming ideas is getting dry. You can tell. And if you guys agree with me, you all need to speak up and make a difference. And I'm not even expecting this video to be up there, you know? I'm not even expecting me to get a lot of views for this video. But if you ever come across this video, please listen to what the hell I'm saying, because I know what I'm saying. I see it. And if we don't, ideas are gonna go weak. Even if they are new, ideas are gonna turn to shit. Because people are not going in the right direction they should be going to. And that is why we need to make a stand. And like I said, guys, I told you guys why I want to see new ideas. Because I love gaming so much, and I love when different developers express their ideas. So we gamers can experience and inhabit the world that they're presenting us. From something new. Not something that's bullshit and recyclable and repetitive. You know? That's why. We need to make a damn change. I feel like I said basically everything that was on my mind, on my chest, and as a whole, my mentality when it comes to the gaming industry and everything nowadays. But, you know, I just felt like expressing it because I felt like someone needs to say something about this. And I'm pretty sure there are not only me, but I'm pretty sure there are many, many, various other YouTube channels and other gamers in the world that do and or don't have YouTube channels that feel the way I do on my perspective of this. And, you know, that's just how I feel. You know, I feel that way. And I feel like we should definitely make a change. And I don't mean to sound like I feel like gaming is like a world that no other type of entertainment can take on. And some people may say, oh, gaming is just a controller in your hand and just looking at the TV. No, that's not what the fuck gaming is. Gaming is something movies, books can't do. You wanna know why? Because in gaming, you are playing a story that geniuses of ideas and creations built. You are in the driver's seat, taking on various stories. And you're also taking on people's imaginations that they're expressing through gaming. You're not just playing a goddamn game. No. You are playing something that people are expressing through imagination, and I love imagination. I love it. Because imagination does so many things reality can't do. And it's true. You know? How, you know, for example, in reality, you know, when are you going to be able to, I don't know, Let's say you're disabled and you really wanted to play football. How are you going to make a touchdown? When in games you can make a touchdown, you know? I mean, this may sound a little silly, but still, you know, you have games are let you do things that you aren't able to do. That's what I love about them. Whether it's in reality, you know. And I'm not talking about that stupid shit, like killing people in real life. I'm not talking about that. That's fucking stupid. I'm talking about, you know, just imagination. I mean, like riding a dragon. Something awesome like that. You know, without harming anyone. You can't do that in real life. You could do it in video games, you know. But, you know, that's what I really like about gaming. You know, it basically takes you on a joyride of imagination to doing things you can never do in reality, you know, and I love that, because it takes you to a whole nother world you can inhabit by people that are expressing their imaginations, you know, and, well, guys, this video is basically coming to an end, and I don't mean to sound sad, mad, but I just really had to get my damn, point across that was on my mind and chest. I just really wanted to get my point across, and I really wanted you guys to hear it. So, you know, thank you guys for watching. Like, subscribe, comment, and I really doubt this video will even get 100 views, and I doubt it, you know, but, I mean, it was worth it. At least when people come across this video, hopefully, they'll know what's really up when it comes to the gaming industry and everything, because I believe my point of view on this gaming industry and everything I said in this video is right and correct 100% because I see it. Thank you guys for watching. This is Guns of Sympathy. Please like, comment, subscribe, do whatever your little heart desires, and I'll see you on my next video. And hopefully I'll actually sound happy, because I just wanted to actually sound serious about this, because, guys, in reality, it's all true. So thank you guys for watching. Peace out. Have an awesome Saturday. Even though in New York here it's raining like hell, and it's cloudy as fuck, but hey, whatever. Bye, guys.